My name is Liliana Chukoy. I represent the research team of Phycobiotechnology Laboratory of the Institute of Microbiology and Biotechnology. Our laboratory has several research directions, including nanobiotechnology. We study the processes of biosynthesis and the biofunctionalization of nanoparticles using microalgae and cyanobacteria, as well as the effects of nanoparticles on various organisms. Our partner in this research is the Joint Institute of Nuclear Research from Dubna, Russia. The topic of my presentation is silver nanoparticles as stimulators in biotechnology of Porphyridium Prientum. Silver nanoparticles are widely applied in the various fields such as optoelectronics, biomedicine, cosmetology, food packaging, biosensing, water treatment, and other. While the problem of their release into environment and toxicity of living organisms is one of the most intensively studied. Microalgae and cyanobacteria, as primary producer in food chain, are the most commonly used organisms for assessing the toxicity of nanoparticles, and their toxic effect depend on shape, size, chemical composition, concentration, solubility, degree of dispersion of nanoparticles, characteristics of microalgae cells, and equally important, the environment. At the same time, silver nanoparticles can stimulate different processes in the cells of microalgae and cyanobacteria. For instance, polyethylene glycol-coated small-sized nanoparticles enhance the productivity of Gonorrhoea salvina and carotene-containing biomass. Small nanoparticles in polyethylene glycol-coated were non-toxic or showed low toxicity toward Cyanobacterium arthrospira platensis, grown in a closed system. Porphyridium Prientum is a marine red microalga known as a producer of phycoerythrin, omega-3 polyunsaturated fatty acids, and sulfated polysaccharides known to inhibit retrovirus replication. Meanwhile, various substances have been proposed as stimulator for biosynthetic processes of porphyridium. Organic compounds, mineral compounds, 3D transitional metal complexes. Porphyridium Prientum can serve as matrix for biosynthesis of metal nanoparticles. It has also been shown that cadmium selenide nanoparticles, which are very toxic to most of the microorganisms tested, ensure an increase in the amount of porphyridium biomass. This stimulating effect can be explained by the formation of hybrid nanoparticle phycoerythrin system, which capture very efficient light energy. Using microalga Porphyridium Prientum, a method for testing the toxicity of nanoparticles has been developed. This method has already patented. So you can see that the effect of different nanoparticles on porphyridium are quite diverse and differ from case to case. Therefore, it is necessary to accumulate as much data as possible on this subject, which will reveal a certain pattern reflecting the relationship between living organisms and the nanoparticle. In this investigation, we aimed to elucidate the possibility of applying a small silver nanoparticle as stimulators in the biotechnology of microalga Porphyridium Prientum. Silver nanoparticles stabilized in the polyethylene glycol manufactured by the M9 company from Tolyatti, Russia, Also, 10 and 20 nanometer silver nanoparticles stabilized in citrate produced by Sigma were used. It was necessary that nanoparticle produced by Togliatti company to be studied in order to confirm their size and shape. The zeta potential value determined for analyzed nanoparticle indicating the high stability of the colloidal system. The X-ray diffraction method was used to examine nanoparticle. In diffractogram obtained are present the peaks characteristic for silver crystals of cubic and hexagonal shape. The Scherer equation was used to determine the average size of crystallites. According to the calculated data, the average size of silver nanoparticles was 12 nanometers. Silver nanoparticles were added in concentration between 0.01 and 1 micromole prior to the inoculum was added. Microalgal cells were in contact with nanoparticle throughout the entire cultivation cycle. At the end, the biomass was collected, its quantity and the content of proteins and carbohydrates were determined. In this study, silver nanoparticles stabilized with the polyethylene glycol in concentration of 0.01 and 0.25 micromole enhanced the growth of Porphyridium creatum, while in concentration range of 0.05 micromole, there was a tendency toward a decrease in the amount of biomass. In the case of citrate stabilized nanoparticles, these are the second and third columns, series of columns in this picture. At first glance, it seemed that no specific pattern of action was revealed. In fact, such a response is known in biology and pharmacology as a wave-shaped effect. Thus, the amount of porphyridium biomass tend to increase under the influence of silver nanoparticle stabilized in citrate with a size of 10 nanometers, second series of columns, added in concentration of 0.01 to 0.05 micromoles. At a concentration of 0.25 micromoles, the amount of biomass is at the control level, and at concentration of 0.5 micromoles, it is significantly higher than in the case of control. At a concentration of 1 micromoles, a significant decrease in biomass production is already observed. Similar fluctuations are observed in the case of nanoparticle with a size of 20 nanometers. The third series of columns. One of the response of porphyridium culture to stress was accelerated synthesis and accumulation of carbohydrate in biomass. Starting from the biological role of sulfated polysaccharides, which constitute an important fraction of carbohydrate, and the fact that porphyridium creatum is grown on an industrial scale to obtain these substances, this parameter was determined in the resulting biomass. Concentration of silver nanoparticle stabilized in pig first series of column that stimulate biomass production also resulted in an increase in carbohydrate content by more than 30%. Silver nanoparticles stabilized in citrate at 10 and 20 nanometer in size, second and third series of cold ones in the picture. A different concentration produce a 20% increase in carbohydrate content. Those studied silver nanoparticles stimulate the accumulation of carbohydrate in biomass, and the effect depends on the concentration of nanoparticles. Protein content is one of the most important biochemical parameters of the biomass quality. In most experimental variants, the amount of protein in porphyridium biomass was at the control level, the series of lines. The concentration were determined for all type of used nanoparticle, which acted as stimulators of protein accumulation in biomass. Thus, for silver nanoparticle stabilized in TIG, a concentration of 0.5 micromole was established with increased the protein content by 39%. The same concentration of the silver nanoparticle stabilized in citrate of 10 and 20 nanometers provide an increase in the amount of protein by 32% and 18%. The stimulatory effect of silver nanoparticle was recorded due to the contact of nanomaterials with microalgal cell during the cultivation, and not during a short time contact as in most published studies. Maintaining algal productivity at an acceptable level indicate the lack of toxic effect of the studied nanoparticle within the limit of applied concentration. This makes it possible to develop technologies for the cultivation of microalgae Porphyridium cruentum, in which nanoparticles act as stimulators that ensure the directed accumulation of certain compounds in biomass. The concentration of nanoparticle was the main factor and determined changes in biochemical composition of microalgae as a result of the activation mechanism for the accumulation of carbon reserves, or the use of these reserves for other groups of substances, for example, for proteins. Therefore, screening of the doses of nanoparticles can reveal the optimal concentration for directing biosynthetic processes in microalgae and cyanobacteria in order to obtain biomass with a programmed biochemical composition. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much for your report. Questions, please, dear colleagues? Will tell, please, that instead of toxic influence on the microorganism, silver has the stimulating effect on macroalgae. That's why. Why it happens that instead of the killing of the microorganism, silver, instead of toxic influence, has such a good and obvious stimulating effect? Up to 30%, you have increasing the biomass up to 30% using nanoparticles, silver nanoparticles, yes?
Yes, in protein. Toxic effect is characteristic for ions of arginine and not for eukaryotic organisms such as porphyridium, but on bacteria, as cyanobacteria, spirulina platensis, but we have demonstrated that for spirulina nanoparticles of argent in the range of concentration can be not toxic.
Stimulating for spirulina also.
Also, it can be stimulated because the effect of nanoparticle and the effect of ions are very different for the living organisms. And this stimulated effect is not too good because it can be associated with the accumulation of the products of lipid peroxidation and the biomass. Our investigation, this investigation is a little part of a complex investigation in the area of biofunctionalization of a nanoparticle by living organisms, microorganisms, and the effect of this biofunctionalization nanoparticles on rat, for example, in our study, accumulation in the organs, clearance after the experience. This is only a little part of an complex investigation. The stimulating is not always very good processes. It can be investigated in the complex of other processes and living organisms themselves.
Okay, that's why it is the method increasing of biomass production. Using this technology, you can increase the biomass up to 30% to increase. Okay. Thank you once again.